Well, what can I say except thank you? My heartfelt thanks really go out to each and every one of you for all the help that you have given me and for the friendship and the vote of confidence that you have given me. Every person in this room worked very, very hard, and there's no way I can thank you enough for your kindness, your generosity, and your caring about this community and for the values and priorities that we share and that we will continue to share and continue to fight for. So I thank you all very much. My staff also in the district and in D.C. have worked so hard for the constituents of the District of 24 that I can't thank them enough either for giving them the kind of service that they deserve. So, a few minutes ago, I called Sandy Adams and I congratulated her. You know, this is a great country that we live in, and I certainly respect the process. So we all have to say this is what the voters have decided they want, and we respect that, and we'll move forward. Many of us in this room have worked together for many years. You know that my run for political office came from the basis of community service, and that's why I ran. And so I considered my 2 years as an extension of that community service that I've given for my entire 37 years here in this community. And I am honored, frankly, that the people of Florida's 24th Congressional District gave me the opportunity to represent them in Congress and to extend that public service. Obviously, I'm not pleased with the outcome. We all would have preferred a different outcome, at least all of us in this particular room. But I can say with confidence that much of what we have done over the last 24 months are things that I think will ensure a brighter future for our communities, for our state, and for our nation. And that much of what we did was designed to improve the quality of life for the most people, the middle class, the working class, the hard-working people of America who make this the great country that it is, and we've laid a foundation to ensure a brighter future. And I certainly hope that this Congress will continue to work with the President and try to find consensus and compromise on those things that we all know are important to make this great country what it is and to ensure that quality of life for the future. All of those changes that we made are not enough. And there's more to be done, and I certainly hope that they will find the way to do that and continue to work on the, as I said, on the foundation that we laid. In the meantime, whatever happens, you all know that I will be dedicated to this community, continue to be a community activist and engaged in trying to ensure that people right here in District 24 in Volusia County are a part of my heart and soul, and that I will always try to do what I can to help them to have greater lives as we move forward. And I will always consider it an honor that you gave me to go to Congress as Congress Grammy Suzanne Kosmas for the 24th Congressional District. Much of what we did, and I know this to be true, that the things that my staff did for the constituents in this district will always be remembered as great acts done for the right reasons. And I hope that, as I said, we'll build on what we did over the last 2 years and ensure that the future is bright. So thank you all very much. I can't tell you how much I appreciate your volunteering for me, giving to me, and extending your friendship and your vote of confidence. Thank you.
We love you.